Guys, welcome to a tutorial meant to teach you guys how to install Python for Android. That's right, I'm going to be showing you guys a brief way you can actually run Python scripts on Android. You can make cool projects, cool apps, cool games and cool stuff on Python with your Android device. Now, when making apps or whatever you want or GUIs with your Android device, you have to use a Python app, that's the Qpython for Android app. And to get that app, you need to use Google Play Store to download it, or you can just download it from a server or whatever you want, or from the internet, anywhere. But I'm gonna be using Google Play because it's kind of the easiest way to get the app, and it also has the latest version always. So Qpython for Android, or Python for Android, is basically an app that allows you to run Python scripts on your Android device, and it's still kind of having issues with running some kind of modules on Python, but the updates that's coming in has been really impressive so far, and I think they'll do better in future updates. So in the meantime, let's just get this done so we can have the Python for Android installed without much wasting time. Okay, the first thing you need to do is I need to head to Google Play Store, and once you're at Google Play Store, you go over to this search bar, click on it, it loads up a bit and it just tells you to type in something. So we're going to be typing Qpython 3. So Qpython 3 is what we're going to be searching for, and just press enter or go or whatever yours says. Now this is the one we're going to be downloading. You might see something like this and this or this, whatever you see. But this is the kind of advanced one we'll be using. And as you can see here, I have mine installed. I couldn't wait because it's just so exciting to have a mobile version of Python with you everywhere you go. It's just so cool. Okay, so we're going to be using Qpython 3 for Android. So let's just open that up. And you want to be using one that has this logo. And not this logo or this logo, just this logo. So let's open it up. Now, I made a video about installing Python, but it was really short and I didn't think I explained things a bit better there. So I am making this video to just explain for you guys how Qpython 3 works and basically the updated version and what it does and things like that. So I'm just going to be making this video to just show you guys how you can actually get some cool stuff working on Qpython and some stuff you need to know about Python itself. So as you can see here, there has been an update that says big update you should not miss, supposed to switch to 3.6 in settings, need to install Qpy 36 first at this link. We're going to be talking about that later. Please switch to Python 3.2 if it doesn't work, for it's a better feature and will improve it as soon. Okay, I'm not going to read that, I'm not good at reading. Okay, it says run blah 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 blah. You can read that on your own. I'm not gonna go through that. This is just brief explanation for the new version, the update they've made. Let's just close out of this. And we're gonna be installing Python for Android. As you can see, I've already installed mine. So I'm just gonna open mine up because I can't uninstall and install again. It's kind of a long process. So when you install yours, you can pause this video and install yours and just play it and just follow the step as I do it. So I'm just gonna open mine up. Now it takes me to a part where you see the Python stuff. Now if you notice, or if you've watched my previous video on installing Python for Android, you notice that I just have the console, editor, programs and the community. But in this new version we have the Qpy and the course. And this Qpy and the course is what I'm gonna be explaining to you guys basically most on. But first of all, let me just talk to you guys about the console. And for those of you viewers who have watched this video before about the editor, the console, programs and the community, just bear with us for a while. We'll get to this part where we explain this stuff. So I'm just going to the console. Now the console is basically a place in Python where your code is run. So when you write code in Python in your editor, it takes you to this part where your code is run. So whatever you write here in the console, it just kind of spits it out as it compiles your code and just runs it. So basically, Python has its own compiler, and you don't have to compile your code and run. So it just compiles your code for you and runs it and spits out the output. Immediately you click enter in this part. So basically, that's how it works in the console. This is where your code is run. Now the editor is where you write code. As I've told you before, it's kind of a place where you write code, and, you know, print, blah blah blah, and rest. You just write your code, and it takes your code to the console, and it runs your code over there. Now, the programs. This is kind of a place where built-in Python programs are stored. And when you write a program or build a new project, you can just take it over here and just save it here, whatever you want. Like, you can see this test.py. Let's open this one up. It's loading. Yeah, this is just a simple file that has been made in a new version. I don't know what this does. It's kind of confusing. I'm not gonna waste my time on this, but just research that on your own. But these are basically built-in Python programs that says different stuff or does different things. So let's head back and let's check out other stuffs. Now, this tool is what I'm going to be talking to you guys about last. So this is the community. The last video I made, I didn't really go into this in details. So let's just go into this now. I'm going to be using my browser. Now, the community is basically a Google Plus kind of stuff that you can meet users, interact with them on Google Plus, solve issues based on programs that were not fully made well on Qpython, and so on and so forth. So it's based on Google Plus, and I'm not really logged in now, and it says it has 737 members. You can join if you want to, but you have to ask to join and just contribute to the community and Python GitHub page and so on and so forth. They could really use programmers like you. So I'm not just gonna be dealing with that now. Let me head back to my tutorial. That aside, let's talk about the QPyPy. Now the QPyPy is basically a kind of library installer. It's a module installer, and we'll be talking about modules later on and how to install QPyPy and how you can actually install modules with QPyPy. If you don't want to use QPyPy, you can also use the Python pip installer for Python. You can also use pip to install packages, and pip is kind of a bit easier to use. I don't really know if you guys agree with me, but to me, I think pip is kind of easier to use. But that aside, this is the library section where you can install libraries and modules in Python. If you don't understand what modules in Python are, or Python, what am I saying? If you don't understand what libraries or modules are in Python, don't worry, you can just subscribe to this channel and I'll explain that for you in later videos. Now, the course in Python is kind of a place where you can go and study QPython stuff. You know, anything you want to know about QPython is in this layer right here. So they have a lot of stuff that can educate you about QPython, the course, the guide, home, AIPY, and also their GitHub page that helps you view some kind of built-in code or built code already. So this is basically your page for your course. And let's just close out this. Let's get back to our tutorial. Now, this area I'm going to be talking to you guys is very important, guys. So basically, pay attention and watch this video to the end and don't miss any of it. Now, this about is just the version and stuff like that. You know, you guys should not be listening to about right now because it's already made. Now, this part is something very, very important. It says switch to Python 36 now. So let's click OK. Now, something I want to get straight to you guys is let's use Play Store. When using QPython and it asks you to update to Python 36, the beta version, I don't really recommend this, but if you guys still want to upgrade to 3.6, you can. But I have used this version before and I'm telling you guys, there has been a lot of downfalls, man. I have been trying to use this program sometimes, this app sometimes, it just crashes. And let's just see the comments. Let's see what some people are saying about this. So It says, okay, crashes, blah, 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 reinstall, doesn't crash, not. But YouTube.deal, still not working, stuff like that. Just see the rating over here. One, this guy gave it five stars. But overall rating, I think the average is about 3.5, and it's not really impressive compared to the other one that had about 4.3 or 4.4. So let's get back to our tutorial. Now, as for the privacy and policies, just the rules and your policy and stuff like that, this is to check if there's a new version released, and this is if you want to rate the app, you can just link you to the Google Play Store so you can rate it. This is to give you the feedback, or to give them the feedback of what you've experienced using the app so far. And this root mode is basically if you're a root user, and this library manage is kind of a way to manage your libraries, your modules in Python, the installed and uninstalled, where you can actually install them and just delete them if you want to. This SL4A service basically means scripting layer for Android. We'll talk about this in our later video, so just hit subscribe to get that. Default program is the program that runs from your script or from your libraries on default. So if you want to reset your stuff, this is where you can go to just reset the old app. And this is the Qpython link to directly lead you to Qpython. We'll talk about this later and installation. FTP service is also something I should tell you guys about. Guys, this is very cool, but I'm sorry to say sometimes it has issues with the app. Well, the FTP service allows you to write code. It kind of connects you to your PC and Mac OS or whatever you're working with. So when you build a project with your device and just want to transfer it to your Windows OS or Mac OS, this is a really good way to do that. So that's what the FTP service does. It helps you links your Android device to your PC and so on. So that's all for this video, guys. But before I go, I'm gonna be showing you guys stuff you should do to appreciate this video if it helps you guys. So just hold on, I'm gonna pause this video, and when I play, I'm gonna show you guys the coolest stuff around. As you can see here, guys, I am on YouTube, and please do not exit this video. I just want to say something to you guys really quick. Well, this channel, I don't know when you watch this video what time it will be, but this is a new channel and I'm trying to improve it. So please, guys, just head to search bar, type in TechMond, and just click on search. The search should load up and take some time. I have kind of slow internet connection. My PC is freezing, man. Yeah, this is my YouTube channel. It's kind of new and I don't have much subscribers. As you can see now, they're only 37. So please, guys, I want you to just click on this subscribe button and subscribe to the channel. Let's open this one up. Let's see, this is my channel. So please just hit subscribe, and no, not unsubscribe, subscribe. Sorry, I don't know why it's freaking showing me this right now, but just hit subscribe. And once you hit subscribe, just click on this bell icon right here and you get notified every time I release a new video. That'll be all for now, guys. Please like this video and subscribe to my channel to get more future videos on Qpython and also other programming languages I'll be dealing with, and also other gaming videos I'll be releasing, guys. So you guys don't want to miss out on those, so please just subscribe, and I'll see you guys on our next tutorial. Thank you all for watching. I'll see you guys next time.